Hi, good afternoon folks, it's Simon here at Vans Today in Worcester, and I'm here to give you a video walk around of this 2020 Vauxhall Combo. It is the 1.5 CDTI Sportive, so the Sportive being sort of their top of the range specification. It's a one keeper from new vehicle, come direct off the lease company with 38,000 warranted miles on it. For those of you that haven't seen any of our videos before, the purpose of our videos is to give you a warts and all video walk around of the van, so you get an idea of exactly what it is that you're buying, and then you can make that informed decision whether this is the vehicle for you or not. Now there are 50 to 60 photos of the van on our website as well, so feel free to cross-reference to there as well. Now let's get started, shall we? We always tend to start up here on the roofs. Hasn't come in with any form of roof rack fitted to it or anything. But as you can see, pretty straight and tidy up there. Coming down onto your windscreen, the windscreen is in good overall condition. There are no major stone chips or cracks to worry about. And then down onto the bonnet. Bonnet is in good overall condition. Again, no major damage to point out to you. You will always get a little micro chipping on the vehicles. Obviously it is a used vehicle. The front end of it could be chipped, but these little marks here actually will come out. A little bit of dirt on there. It's just been about 48 hours since it's come back from the valeter, so I haven't had a chance to photo it. And then front end of the vehicle, your front grills, front bumper, those are all in good condition with no damage. Your passenger side headlamp unit is in good order. They are automatic lights on these Sportives as well. Front bumper corner, passenger side, also in good condition, no heavy scuffing. Look down the side profile of the vehicle and hopefully you can see there's a nice mirror finish to that paintwork. And again, there are no major dents or dings to point out to you. I know we're battling the sunshine a little bit, the winter sun this afternoon. Driver's side headlamp unit, again, that's all in good condition. Driver's side front bumper corner, again, all in good order as well. Have a look down the side profile of the van from this angle and again, nice mirror finish to it. We've just got a bit of sunlight coming through the shadows of the trees, but she's all in very straight, tidy condition. Driver's side front wing with side repeater, that's all looking good. Driver's side front steel wheel, factory hubcap. We have a Hankook tyre on there. The tyre itself has plenty of tyre tread depth, as you can see. Mirror unit, mirror cap. I mean, mine a little mark there, but nothing major. Mirror itself is all good. Mirror glass, again, overall good condition. Driver's side door, as you can see, is in good overall condition as well. Alignment to wings and rear quarter, all aligning up nicely. Driver's side door handle and lock in overall good condition. Now, it has obviously just been used by painter decorator. We've got to go around it. There's just minor little bits of paint, as you can see here. A little bit on the handle, little bits and pieces. So we will go around it and just get rid of all of those for you. It is actually just on the surface of the van, so it's easily enough sortable. Get down low, check out your lower sills. Those are in good condition with no major damage. Your protective strip on the side of the vehicle is in good order, again with no damage. Driver's side rear quarter, again overall good condition. Now there is a little mark and a little very faint scratch here. Now I can't really get my nail into that, so I think, if I'm honest with you, with a bit of a flat and a mop, that is going to come out, and I do think so for that mark there as well. Okay, so ask if you're interested in the vehicle, phone us and ask us. That's the easiest way, isn't it? Driver's side rear steer wheel, factory hubcap, another Hankook tyre. That tyre again has loads of tyre tread depth, as you can see there. Hubcap's in good condition. Have a look down the profile of the van from this angle, and again you can see that nice reflection to the paintwork. And let's just give you the overview from the side of the vehicle here. I think the van looks really well in this colour as well. I think it's been a really good saleable colour for us, this colour. They don't tend to last very long with this mileage on and in this price range, to be fair. Rear light unit on the driver's side, as you can see, is good. Rear bumper corner is in overall good condition. This is just a little bit of excess polish there, so that will come off. To the back of the vehicle, rear barn doors on a 60-40 split. Again, overall good condition. I know the shadows aren't helping us there with the paintwork, but just give you some close-ups. So high level brake lights, all good. Door edges, that is just a little mark that's on the surface of the paint, so that should just flat and mop off. Coming down, again, a little bit of excess paint from the previous gentleman's profession, so that will just clear off, as it will on the door edges as we get lower down as well. Rear bumper itself, though, kind of indicates how the vehicle's been used, which is not very heavy, is it? Because generally, they're quite scratched up. Now, I'm not going to say it's not without its marks. However, I'm sure we've probably got a spare bumper protector that we can pop on there for you anyway. And then opening the vehicle again, it's not been cleaned properly in the back, but your factory bulkhead, overall good condition. It's not like dented or battered to death, is it? The sides of the vehicle, where they should be, are ply lined. You know, minor little scratching on the metalwork there. And then in the back, you have a ply lined floor. Obviously, a bit of paint spillage there. I think we can potentially get rid of a lot of that paint spillage. If we can't, the easiest thing to do is just paint it in grey garage floor paint. And that just, you know, makes it look like a new piece of ply then. So we can do either of those, really. Inside of the rear doors, nice and tidy. Again, whilst there are elements of wear and tear on them, that again, they're not battered to death or anything like that. And then to the passenger side, your passenger side headlamp unit, all good order. Your passenger side front rear bumper corner is also in good order. Have a look down the passenger side here, and then you can see, really looks really nice, doesn't it? Passenger side steel wheel, factory hubcap in good order. We have a Landsale tyre. That tyre has plenty of tyre tread depth, as you can see. Behind this flap here, we have your AdBlue filler and your diesel fuel filler. Upper quarter on this side all looking good. Lower quarter and arch on this side also looking good. Your sliding door on this side is in nice condition. Everything aligns up to how it should be. Getting down low again, check out your lower sills, also in good order as well, no damage. And the same with your protective strip down the side of the vehicle as well. Passenger side door handle and lock good. Passenger side sliding door handle all good. Passenger side door glass all looking good. And then the passenger side door itself is in overall good condition. Passenger side mirror unit, again, all good. And then passenger side front wing with side repeater, also in good condition. Passenger side front steel wheel, factory hubcap, in amazingly good condition for a passenger side front hubcap. Hankook tyre, so you've got three Hankooks and a Landsale on, and that's all looking good. So, opening up the front, we have passenger side front door card also in good condition. Your door shuts are clean and tidy, as you can see. Your entry sills and plastics on this side are also in good condition. Your flooring inside, there's your bonnet release. Passenger side carpets in good order, and then dashboard, etc., all looking good. We have glove box with book pack in there as well. Above your head there is additional storage, as you can see where our price board is shoved out of the way at the moment. And then your passenger side seat trim. There's a little bit of paint there, and there's a little bit of paint over there, okay? I'm fairly sure we can get rid of the vast majority of that. We have a couple of price numbers that have fallen out of the price sign that we couldn't find previously. And then having a look under your bonnet here. So bonnet release is this little handle here. And then underneath your bonnet, as you can see, you have your fuse box over here, your factory battery there, your bonnet stays there. Engine, all looking good. No, you don't get an engine cover with a commercial vehicle. Dipstick, engine oil filler, windscreen wash, and then your coolant bottle is over there as well. No contamination in it. And as you can see, everything is looking clean and tidy under there as well. And then under here, your driver's side door card is in good order. Your driver's side entry seals and plastics. Got a little bit muddy from us getting in and out of it, but all good. The floor carpet, again, looks messier here than it, I think it does in real life. The iPhone camera highlights huge amounts of dirt for some strange reason, but we'll get that re-cleaned for you. It's obviously us getting in and out of it. A little bit of paint here, okay. Again, I think that is just bit of emulsion, so with a bit of scrubbing we'll get that sorted out on it for you. Auto lights, headlamp levelers, dashboard illumination, cup holders. We have additional storage here for you, and then we have a multi-function steering wheel, and on that steering wheel you've got cruise control and speed limiter. And then over here we have a bit of voice activation, your telephone answering system. Actually, let me turn that ignition off because some people like to see me start it. And then volume controls on there as well. So there is your dashboard, okay? It's 38,169 miles. Fires up nicely. All your test lights come on and then they all go out. You're just then left with the door open light, which if I close the door, that goes out, and then your handbrake light's on there as well, because obviously we've got the handbrake on. Wipers on the right-hand stalk. We have indicators and main beam on the left-hand stalk. We have DAB, FM and AM with Bluetooth telephone and Bluetooth music in the centre here. Hazard warning light, central locking, air conditioning, electronic stability programme, 5-speed manual gearbox. Reverse gear is all the way to the right and back, and then that will activate your park distance display that you see on there as well. In between your seats, you've got a nice couple of hot cup holders down there, a bit of storage, your handbrake, because this one has a manual handbrake, as opposed to the Peugeot Citroen, which has a electronic handbrake. But everything's nice and clean down there. There's no old McDonald's or anything like that. Top of the dashboard's all nice and clean as well. Interior lights and SOS buttons, etc. on the top of your head there. And that, my friends, is about it. It's a really nice mileage van, isn't it? 38,000 miles. It's on a 2020, so that's less than 10,000 miles per year. One keeper from new. It's in Sportive, which gives you a really good specification. It's in that lovely light grey metallic as well, which, as I've already mentioned, is a good saleable colour for us. Little bit of TLC on the cleaning, bit of touching in and polishing, but essentially it's a nice straight example. Now, there are 50 to 60 photos of the van on our website. Our website is vanstoday.com. We are Vans Today Worcester, based in the centre of the country, offering you nationwide delivery, part exchange and finance. And if you're worried about who you're buying off, then please check out our reputation online. We have reviews on Google, I think, which is the most important. And we have presence on Facebook, LinkedIn, Instagram. And you are watching this video on our YouTube channel. So like and subscribe for all of our latest purchases. Thank you very much, my friends. Hopefully that gives you a good idea of exactly what it is that you're buying. Cheers.